Paul Newman's a man faced with one final chance.
You want to be a failure?
Will he be able to face the verdict Sunday?
Meet the remarkable Kimmy Gray. She turned her public housing project from a rundown haven for drugs and crime into a safe, thriving community. Tuesday on 1986.
Up next on tonight's Scene at 6, Clarksville police investigate the shooting deaths of an Austin Peay University music professor and his male nurse. And a former Metro substitute teacher pleads not guilty to charges he molested 5 female students.
Also tonight in our series Last of the Past, we'll take a look at what came before computers. And we'll take a look back and say thanks for the memories to a departing Dan Miller.
These stories and more news coming up next on the Scene at 6.
Have you driven a Ford?
We had promised Deborah on her 16th birthday that we would help her get an automobile.
I had my heart set on a Taurus.
We were really impressed with the Taurus, the way it drives, the way it handles, and so forth.
It handles really well on the highway, and even in the city. It's just like you're gliding on top of the road.
Test drive the affordable Ford Taurus sedan at your Ford dealer today.
Deb's mom and I, we use it every chance we get, too.
Only when I let them.
Come feel the freshness.
Tropicana.
Tropicana orange juice shades your morning with a taste so fresh, so pure, so natural.
Tropicana.
Consistently fresh taste every day of the year. The taste could only be one.
Tropicana.
Feel the freshness. It's pure Tropicana.
WSMV, Nashville. From Channel 4 News, this is The Scene at 6 with Dan Miller, Demetria Kaladimos, Bill Hall, and Rudy Kalis.
Good evening. Police in Clarksville are investigating the shooting deaths of a wheelchair-bound music professor and his live-in attendant. Police believe the professor was the victim of a murder-suicide. Barb Kramer reports that those that worked with Dr. Aaron Schmidt are shocked by his death.
I was absolutely shocked. I couldn't believe it. It was a sad end for a marvelous man.
For years, music professor Dr. Aaron Schmidt battled the paralyzing effects of multiple sclerosis, but still he continued teaching. Last night, Schmidt died, killed by a bullet. The 59-year-old Schmidt was found dead in his bed, shot twice in the head. His live-in attendant was dead in the next room, a bullet hole in his head. Police believe the attendant, Dave DiRico, killed Schmidt during an argument, then killed himself.
From what it looks like right now, it's probably his work, the way he worked and cared for Mr. Schmidt.
In what way? What was it that they weren't happy with?
Just his performance and attitude toward it.
Schmidt's wife was held hostage during the argument. At one point, she was forced at gunpoint to help DiRico pack his clothes.
He told my mother, at one point, he was looking for something to tie them up and gag them. And evidently that he was going to leave. And that's it. I really don't know exactly what triggered what happened.
Pat Schmidt was able to get away from DiRico and run for help. But when police arrived, both men were dead. Schmidt was a music professor at Austin Peay for 30 years. He taught marching band, jazz band, and concert band. In recent years, he was confined to a wheelchair and needed constant supervision. Friends say his work kept him going. In 1977, Schmidt was named Tennessee's Handicapped Citizen of the Year.
He was kind of an inspiration to all of us.
Dr. Ken Olson says Schmidt took personal interest in his students and was well known for recruiting out-of-state students to the regional school.
In spite of the long battle he had with multiple sclerosis, he laughed easily, was an active and effective teacher, and made us all feel good. We shall all miss him greatly.
An autopsy will be done on Schmidt and DiRico. Police are awaiting final lab results before closing the case. Funeral arrangements for Schmidt are incomplete. Barb Kramer, Channel 4 News.
A former substitute teacher for the Metro school system today pleaded not guilty to 7 counts of aggravated sexual battery. Police say Charles Osborne molested 5 of his female students at the Jerry Baxter School. Osborne says he is innocent. During a morning arraignment, Judge Randall Wyatt revoked Osborne's $10,000 bond. Friday, Judge Wyatt will decide whether the bond should be increased to $100,000. Prosecutors want the higher bond, saying Osborne may try to leave the state.
Authorities in Dixon and Hickman counties say more alleged victims are coming forward to accuse a former elementary school principal of sexual abuse. Yesterday, 35-year-old Marshall Tidwell, who was accused of 5 counts of aggravated sexual battery so far, waived his right to a preliminary hearing in Dixon. Authorities say Tidwell not only abused young boys in his clothing store, but also in his principal's office at East Elementary in Hickman County. The Tennessee Department of Human Services says parents can do something to prevent such sexual abuse from taking place.
I think parents need to start talking with their children as young as 3 to 4 years of age about this, as they do any other safety issues they're dealing with the child, like don't take candy from strangers, don't play in the street, those kind of safety issues, and start bringing up things like your body's your own. If someone touches you, it makes you feel uncomfortable, or it touches you in your private area, or any way they want to refer to it, be sure to tell someone, be sure to say no.
Tidwell's case goes to the Dixon County Grand Jury in early September.
103 Metro school buses were given only a temporary safety approval today after inspections by the State Department of Safety. The 1984, 85, and 86 GMC and Chevrolet large buses were found to have a problem in the braking system. The director of Metro School Transportation says the defect is not life-threatening and the buses will continue to be used. Federal safety engineers are in the process of checking the buses and will report their findings back to the Department of Safety.
Homecoming 86, Crystal Restaurant, Salute, Manchester.
The natural beauty alone is enough to attract visitors to the old stone fort outside Manchester. But here is preserved some of Tennessee's oldest known history. The area was settled by prehistoric Indians about the time of Christ. The stone fort was apparently used for tribal ceremonies. Many Indian artifacts discovered here now stand as rich reminders of the area's past.
A Homecoming 86 salute from Crystal Restaurants.
Please,
18.
24.
Yeah.
The irresistible hot and fresh Crystal. Nothing looks like it, nothing tastes like it.
Hearty appetite, boys.
When you've got to have a Crystal, you've got to have a Crystal.
It's Toyota's all-out sellout. The factory challenged Toyota dealers to sell out their huge stock of trucks by month's end. They're throwing out prices to make the best deals of the year on 4x, 2x, and cargo vans. Extra value packages could save you over $900. Factory incentives to dealers could save you even more. Trade-ins may never be higher. Prices may never be lower. Want financing? Your dealer wants to help. You've only got till month's end. Make your best deal now at your Toyota dealer's all-out sellout.
A federal bank examiner today described C.H. Butcher Jr.'s Southern Industrial Bank as, quote, the worst financial institution I have ever examined. FDIC examiner Ronnie Parham of Memphis was the final witness in the 6-week-old fraud trial of Butcher and former SIBC president James Steiner. Jim Travis has more from Chattanooga.
The government has accused C.H. Butcher Jr. and James Steiner of deceiving depositors who later lost more than $25 million. Because, charges the government, Butcher used Southern Industrial as his private piggy bank through an elaborate loan-shifting scheme and tried to hide the losses from examiners. In the witness chair today, this man, FDIC bank examiner Ronnie Parham. In November 1982, Parham headed a team of examiners who descended on Jake Butcher's United American Bank in Knoxville and later examined Southern Industrial's books when Butcher sought federal insurance for his failing loan and thrift. Appearing as a government rebuttal witness, Parham told the 8-woman, 4-man jury that while there's some truth in Butcher's claim that United American's failure had an effect on SIBC, the financial condition at SIBC was irreversible, regardless of the UAB failure. Said Parham, 7 insiders, including C.H. Butcher and SIBC stockholder David Crabtree, had loans totaling $24,819,000. Most, he said, lacked proper security. Parham testified it would have taken at least $23 million in new capital to keep SIBC afloat. For the first time, the FDIC examiner made public the extent of Memphis Congressman Harold Ford's borrowing from C.H. and Jake Butcher. Using these as examples of bad loans, Parham said Ford's loans totaled $891,000. Parham said this indicated preferential treatment. Parham said that after he and other examiners spent more than 1,500 hours going over Southern Industrial's books, he concluded, quote, SIBC was the worst financial institution I have ever examined. SIBC's loan portfolio was the worst I have ever evaluated.
There's much speculation here that it will take the jury at least 2 or 3 days to reach a verdict. But in a case as complex as this, no one's taking any bets. In Chattanooga, Jim Travis, Channel 4 News.
Hippodrome Oldsmobile Nissan is sweeping out the entire inventory, and you can save more than ever. In fact, just bring us a signed buyer's order from any other Oldsmobile or Nissan dealer, and we'll beat their deal on any car we have in stock. And if you buy a new Oldsmobile or Nissan from Hippodrome now, you can beat the price increases. Plus, you can still get low factory financing during our clean sweep sale. But the offer ends soon, so hurry in while there's still time during the clean sweep sale at Hippodrome Oldsmobile Nissan, the uptown dealer with the right kind of deal. Just off the loop at the Broadway exit.
You'll always find great value at Castor Knot, but now you can save 25% on Agner handbags and accessories. Bargain days.
It's Castor Knot.
Here's Bill with the weather, who just broke a button on his neck. What are you, putting on weight?
Now, I'm losing weight around the waist, but I guess my...
It's shifting up to your neck.
My billet's getting fat there, I guess. So I just hope...
Let me see, it looks okay.
I hope. I apologize for being shoddy, I guess.
No, it's all right. Well, I guess this will be one of the last times that we'll turn to each other here and say this.
Yeah, I've got a lot to do before I get back to you, so should I go on to work here?
Yeah,
all right, sir. Panama City, Florida, Dan, Thursday through Saturday, partly cloudy skies each day with a chance of showers and thunderstorms. Afternoon highs will be in the lower 90s, morning lows in the lower to mid-70s. Eureka Springs, Arkansas, Thursday through Sunday, partly cloudy skies each day with isolated showers. Highs low 90s each day, morning lows in the low 70s. Here in Nashville for the last 24 hours, a low this morning, 65, our afternoon high, 87. The city's air quality good today. The pollen count slight. We've had no rainfall the last 24 hours. Folk over at Tullahoma picked up 1/4 inch of rainfall. Congratulations to y'all in Tullahoma. Monthly total for Nashville staying at 3.16 inches, and for the year, 16.29 inches. We're now 16.55 inches below normal. Right now, we have sunny skies, but showers in the area. We'll take a look shortly. 85 degrees, northeasterly wind 9, the pressure rising, relative humidity at 50%. Here's the satellite photograph of the entire lower 48. Considerable cloudiness over the Gulf Coast and virtually the entire Florida Peninsula. Small area of clearing here in the Florida Panhandle. Mostly cloudy skies over the Gulf Coastal states, up the Atlantic seaboard from the seaboard into the Appalachian areas. Other cloudiness associated with an impressive cold front, as you can see, dipping out of James Bay and Hudson Bay down through the northern plains back into the northern plateau region. They had some frost in this portion of the northern Rockies this morning. Precipitation around the country at this hour showing widely scattered showers mainly over the Four Corners area and the plateau region. And again today, unfortunately, the rain showers are not as heavy as we would like to see them for the heavy forest fires that are burning in a large part of the Pacific Northwest. Other showers ahead of that impressive cold front moving into the upper Mississippi Valley, but very heavy rain showers just covering up the previously, I guess we could say previously, drought-stricken southeastern United States. Temperatures are coolest over the northern Atlantic coastal areas and the northern plains. A small area of 60s in there, that's good for them. Temperatures remain, however, quite hot over the south and southwestern portions of the country. The nation's recorded low this morning, 37 at Cutbank, Montana. Newport, Oregon, 52 today at 2 o'clock, 108 today at Thermal in California. Impressive cold front, as we said, producing scattered showers and thunderstorms along with it. Mild over the northeast, except for those areas. Flash flood watches in effect because of the heavy rains over the Carolinas. Frost, as we said today, and cooler over the northwest. Southwest, partly cloudy and hot with isolated showers. Overnight lows look like this, 60s over our area for tomorrow. Another partly cloudy day with a shower here and there. And for temperatures tomorrow, high in the mid to upper 80s. For Friday, partly cloudy skies. Local weather radar scanning 160 miles in all directions, showing widely scattered rain showers over southern Middle Tennessee, heavier thunderstorms northwestern Georgia. Other showers dotting Middle Tennessee into the Cumberland Plateau. We've dipped to 79 degrees on the hill here. Tonight's forecast calling for partly cloudy skies with a few isolated showers earlier, then becoming fair. Low to 66, and for tomorrow, another partly cloudy day with more isolated area showers, high 87, low 65. 5-day forecast, Dan, the last time I'll say this to you, partly cloudy, chance of afternoon showers. Morning lows, mid to upper 60s, afternoon highs, mid to upper 80s.
You want to tell who hit you with that missile? That is the leader of this station, Mike Kettering, the president, the general manager, the inspiration of our maturity and our credibility.
A man I love dearly because he signs my check.
Throwing paper wads. I just never seen anything like it. He's on. There's a nice shot
there
of his backside.
Is, yeah.
Sports is up next after this.
There was a time when life was simple. Finding the right physician was easy. That's why it's so nice to know that even with today's hectic pace, finding the right doctor can still be easy. Just call CareFinders, the free physician referral service of Baptist Hospital. It's the most experienced hospital-based referral service in Middle Tennessee, and it's associated with more than 300 physicians in all specialties. When you need a doctor, call Baptist CareFinders. We'll make the appointment for you. Just call 329-MD for you.
My dad didn't have the words to tell me he loved me. But then, he didn't have to. See, they were written all over his face.
Stay close, I need
Hello?
Your strength.
Dad. Hi. Hey, son. They're not working you too hard, are they? No, Dad.
Let's stay close.
United Way provides mentally handicapped adults with job skills that can make them independent.
United Way.
Sports time. Rudy Kalis. Doing all right?
I'm doing great, thank you. I'm leading with a story that's important because is there any truth to the rumor that salary is part of the reason that that you're grumbling and had to leave?
No, none at all.
Well, then you have nothing to do with Tony Dorsett, I guess.
He's still grumbling, isn't he?
He's still grumbling. He's making half as much. If you knew you were making half as much as the other guy you're going to replace.
It's an interesting thought. I don't know how I'll ponder that while you do this.
All right, something to think about. The grumblings are not over in Dallas. The Cowboys running back Tony Dorsett still says he wants to be traded because of the salary difference between what he's making and Herschel Walker. Well, Dorsett met with the Cowboys owner Tex Schramm yesterday complaining about the fact that Herschel was making twice as much. But Schramm said no way for the trade. Tony will have to play out the year and then see what he can do. There's good news for the Oakland Raiders running back Napoleon McCallum, who was given permission to play for that NFL team on his own time by the U.S. Navy. McCallum has a 5-year commitment to the Navy in front of him, but in the first ruling of this type in Navy history, he will be allowed to mix two worlds as long as it does not conflict with his Navy career. And here locally, former Vanderbilt strength coach E.J. Doc Kreese was settled into his new home in the weight room at Middle Tennessee State University this morning after accepting a non-paying voluntary position as the strength coach of the MTSU Blue Raiders under Boots Donnelly. Kreese is enrolled in the graduate school at MTSU, going for his master's in physical education. Kreese is back in the business he loved so dearly after a difficult year of involvement in the Vandy steroid controversy.
Something which I enjoy doing, and I think I do it pretty good. And, you know, it's a thing to where you really don't, sometimes we forget, we take for granted, you know, what we do. And, yeah, it's been a long time, and it's a daggum good feeling to get back in here. You know, I've had a chance to get out and formulate what my ideas are in training and what my ideas are in strength development, and then coordinate that with the coaches that I've had the opportunity to work with. You know, that's the fun of it. And then, of course, seeing people excel, both on and off the field. You know, that's what it's all about. And that's the part I enjoy, you know. And again, you know, take one day at a time. You know, we're going to work. We'll do the best we can that day. And we'll come back the next day and work just as hard and get, you know, do what we can each day.
Alabama football coach Ray Perkins says that All-American linebacker Cornelius Bennett may not play in the season's opener against Ohio State next week. Bennett has apparently re-injured a hamstring muscle during practice on Monday. If that's the case, the Tide will be without two defensive starters. Tackle Willie Riles is in critical condition after a blood clot in his brain had to be operated on a couple of days ago. Major League Baseball final, Atlanta, 17 hits, beat Chicago by the score of 8-3, and Philadelphia got a no-hitter through 8 innings from Don Carmen, the left-hander, and a solo home run in that game from Juan Samuel, and defeated San Francisco 1-0. Well, in the American League, the Yankees snapped a 3-game losing streak and beat Seattle 5-2.
Nothing on the Dodgers, huh?
Nothing on the Dodgers. No. You were a big Atlanta fan.
I got to turn into a Dodger.
Yeah. When we come back, though, Miller the great athlete will all just marvel, really, moves like a cat.
You going to show that stuff? Okay, thanks, Rudy. More news after this.
So what's the next step for these machines?
Junk power.
You're on your way. K
Capital Chevrolet has three of the world's classiest sports cars to take you there. The Cavalier Z24, a lot of car, but not a lot of money. The powerful streetwise Camaro T-Top Z28. And the one that sets the standard for sports car lovers everywhere, the classic Corvette convertible. So when you know you want more than just a car, Capital Chevrolet will take you there. At Capital Chevrolet, how we do it really does make the difference.
Want to know three great reasons to choose Wesson? Wesson vegetable, corn, and sunflower oil. Three all-natural ways to fry right.
My fried chicken's got to be crispy and juicy, and my oil's got to be Wesson vegetable oil.
What could be better? Good food and the goodness of corn oil. Wesson corn oil.
Eating light is right.
And today's light dishes taste great with Wesson sunflower oil.
Wesson vegetable, corn, and sunflower oil. With every bite, you know you're frying right.
Families disagree about a lot of things.
But I want a dachshund.
No way. They're
But there's one thing they agree on. Lee jeans from Target.
Yes, they are.
No, well, whatever we get, it's going to have to be a watchdog.
A watchdog? They bite. They slobber.
Like men's and women's and denims, just $14.88. Or boys and girls denims, just $12.88.
Mom!
All right, we are getting a cat.
Aww.
Lee jeans, no matter who wears the pants in the family.
Great, a watch cat.
The computer, today it's everywhere. It's in offices and factories, even in the home. One place where computers have caught on is in the news business, newspapers especially. But tonight, Glenn Farley gives us a look at a machine which preceded the computer and is no less fascinating.
Oh, this is probably even more fascinating because the problem with the computer is everything goes on in inside the cabinet and you can't see any of it except what's on the screen. That's not true with this. This is the story of some survivors, some mechanical mediums that are breathing their last yet are hanging in there. These machines were the keepers of history, yet their own history went largely ignored.
Let me assert my firm belief that the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
The representatives of the Emperor of Japan and the Japanese government to sign the instrument of surrender at the places indicated.
Godspeed, John Glenn.
Start. We have liftoff. We have liftoff.
The unbelievable happened. Shots rang out. The president was killed as he passed the Texas School Book Depository.
Because only if you've been in the deepest valley can you ever know how magnificent it is to be on the highest mountain.
It is the machine which set history to type. The medium that lay between the journalist and the printing press. Without this link, the saying, all the news that's fit to print, would have gone more like all the news that's fit to scrawl. It is the Linotype machine, a wondrous piece of pre-computer technology that cast in lead the news of the day and the history of the world. Backwards, of course. Every big city newspaper had them, dozens of them, some up until recent decades. But somehow, this mandatory part of the media machine never had its story told. It was the movies that made heroes out of reporters and editors.
Tell him if you're Reprieve Williams, we'll support him for senator.
What?
Tell him the Morning Post will be behind him, hook, line, and sinker.
But you can't do
Why
that.
Why not?
Because we've been a Democratic paper for over 20 years.
All right, after we get the reprieve, we'll be Democratic again.
It was the movies that let America feel the exhilaration of accelerating presses, presses containing the important type that the Linotype machine continuously cranked out. The idea is simple. The operator types in a word at the keyboard. Out of a chute drops little brass molds containing the letters of the word. Into the molds and out of sight is poured molten lead. The lead hardens quickly, and out pops the word and its accompanying words in the form of a line. The machine then returns the brass molds to their respective pockets, and the cycle continues. Executing this simple idea wasn't so simple, but it worked.
So what's the next step for these machines?
Junk pile.
Junk pile for history's typesetter with this Swiss watch precision? Fortunately, Robert Fraser is kidding about the junk pile. These are Fraser's babies, today setting wedding invitations instead of news stories on world events.
Oh, we used to do a heck of a lot of different variety of work. We planned airplane schedules for once. And different, just anything you mention, nearly we've set them. We even set football tickets, betting tickets.
You think they'll ever go out completely?
I don't know. It's a good question. I think every year, but it holds on.
Some students had no classrooms. Others had no teachers as schools in surrounding counties opened this week. Those were some of the problems caused by student populations expanding faster than some school systems' budgets. Terry Dorsey has a report.
The further away you get from the ninth grade, the harder it is going to be to pass it.
Two ninth grade English classes squeezed into one room at this Rutherford County Junior High. Some students sat in folding chairs. Philip Roberts said it was a strange way to start the school year.
Because there's just no desks there, nowhere to write on, except your lap.
Half of these students were supposed to meet in a portable classroom, but many county schools ran into a problem.
Yes, we were scheduled to have 23 portable classrooms for Rutherford County. And at this date, to my knowledge, we've received none.
School principal Don Jernigan expects five portable classes at his school next week.
On the back, write 12 words that describe you.
In the meantime, the eighth grade science class meets in the cafeteria. Rutherford County schools will remain overcrowded until two new high schools are built and others expanded. That could take 2 or 3 years. Williamson County schools are also overrun with students, especially elementary schools. The older students, fifth graders, were moved out of Grassland Elementary this year. Nevertheless, four classes started without teachers because there were more younger students than expected.
And she's not going to be the teacher all year. She's just substituting for these 2 days.
Kelly King began first grade with two teachers this week. Mary Ann Nelson filled in until her kindergarten class starts next week.
It sets her off a week behind and more than that.
Kelly's mother said she'd rather her child have a teacher than a classroom. But more parents may see both dilemmas as new families move into suburban counties faster than classrooms can be built. Terry Dorsey, Channel 4 News.
Why, sure, it's energy efficient. It's certified.
You betcha it saves energy, guaranteed.
A lot of folks say the house they're selling is an energy saver. If you're not sure, look for this medallion. It assures you a home was thoroughly inspected during and after construction by Nashville Electric Service for energy-saving features. Homes with this medallion are being offered by many home builders in Nashville. Ask to see the Energy Saver Home Medallion that helps you enjoy low energy bills year-round. Don't buy without it.
Where is everybody going? It's the Dash for Cash, now at your Renault Jeep dealer. Dash in and get factory cash back on select Renault and Jeep models. Cash that may be used as a down payment. Get $800 back on a Renault hatchback. $1,000 back on a two-door Jeep Cherokee. $1,000 back on a Jeep Comanche. Make your Dash for Cash today.
See your Middle Tennessee Jeep Renault dealer today.
Handling information quickly and accurately is more than just important. It can be vital. That's why South Central Bell is working with hospitals, providing them custom-designed communication services, allowing them fast, accurate access to medical records and data, creating a unique network of people and technology. For the right answers to your communications needs, there's one name you need to remember. South Central Bell. Call on us.
All right, I don't think I'm going to be too thrilled about this, but Rudy's back with part two of sports.
This is the second segment of sports reserved for the finest athletes in the world.
Yeah, sports is stretching it a bit.
Having played basketball, we used to have a basketball team here and started 12 years ago. And from having been in the locker room with you, I can tell you, folks, I have seen the real Dan Miller.
Yeah,
and
we know each other pretty well.
We know each other well. So with all that in mind, let's take a look at the memory of a great athlete.
Whoa, I found rocker. Crazy. With the right medication, we won't be lazy. Old folks boogie down on the farm. We'll tell they were locked on and on. Bet off pacemaker, matching alarm. Give you just one more chance to spin one more yarn.
Dan, was the team just not psyched for this game?
Aaron, I don't understand the question.
Well, I didn't have the privilege of recruiting Dan or watching him play, but from second-hand information, he had a deadly two-hand jump set shot that got everybody excited.
Ooh, what a great basketball player you were, just to have the coach talk about you that way. But I know how much you love football. Not playing, you never could do that, but you love to come out here to Vanderbilt Stadium on Saturdays and watch the Commodores play football, kind of the highlight of your week, I guess. But you know how long you've been around this town?
I don't know if you realize how old you are. If you started when I was a sophomore in college, now that's a long time ago. But from me and Vanderbilt, good luck to you. What Los Angeles is getting, Nashville's losing.
That was awfully nice of Watson to say, and you deserve it. And that's why I want to take my opportunity to thank you right now. Thank you for being a friend. I was going to do it sitting there next to you, but that might seem a little syrupy, and I know you're a little self-conscious about that, and I probably would be too. But it was 12 years ago this week that I came to Nashville and worked at then WSMTV. 12 years ago, you invited me to your house to let me do your lawn and be your gardener, and I have been faithful ever since. Well, I'm going to miss you. You've been an awfully good friend. You have given me honest advice, and I will always appreciate that. You've shown me that the best thing in the world to do is to try to be yourself, and you've set an example of that yourself as well.
And these burn are surely, truly happy tears. You know what I mean?
Very nice, very nice.
I've got some little things for you, but I'll save them till the end. We'll give you some of that.
Thanks, Rudy. That means a lot to me. We'll be back after this.
True Value Hardware, it's more than a name.
Save energy and money by using Tuck duct tape to seal leaks in air conditioning and heating ducts, as well as around doors and windows. In August, get a 60-yard roll of Tuck duct tape for just $2.99. Look for the Hardware Value of the Month banner at most True Value hardware stores and home centers.
And tell them Pat Summerall sent you.
If you're looking to save thousands on a new car,
look for the red tags of the Pontiac people of Middle Tennessee.
It's our biggest sale of the year.
Sticker prices have been slashed, and every 86 Pontiac is clearly marked with year-end dealer discounts. Grand Ams, Trans Ams, Sunbirds, Fieros, Pontiac 6000s, Parisiades.
All red tags.
Plus, as low as 5.9% GMAC financing could save you over $1,000 more.
Hurry to the sale you've been waiting for.
Our annual red tag sale at the Pontiac people of Middle Tennessee.
There are a lot of people tonight who want to say their goodbyes to Dan Miller, and one of those is Channel 4's media critic Ed Kimbrell.
There is no longer any doubt that news anchors become part of our lives. They're the ones who hold shows together. They're the ones to tell us of the good and bad news of every given day. They're often so much a part of our lives that we talk of them as friends. We even start our conversations with the anchor's name, indicating that we heard the story from a good source. Thus, when anchors leave, it sometimes sets off ripples of concern and interest. The departure of Dan Miller from this station set off waves. For 15 years, he's been the best of the best, keeping a balance of humor and seriousness harder to accomplish than most of us realize. His respect for reporters and colleagues has been obvious. Dan Miller seems to have learned long ago that the news business is a team effort. He never abused that team. He teased them. He'd make them laugh, even at themselves. But he did not seek to offend any of us, viewers or team members. His departure to KCBS Television, the legendary big time of Los Angeles, is overdue. His fans have been saying for years that he should leave Nashville for the bigger lights and better pay of the major markets. His staying so long surprised many, delighted most. There are others in this market who are part of our lives, anchors like Ann Holt and Chris Clark. They are respected professionals doing a solid job of reporting and delivering that ephemeral beast called news. I think we've become spoiled by the high level of professionalism. The nightly news packages are really a kind of modern miracle, presented to us so smoothly we take them for granted. Only a jolt like Dan Miller's decision brings us from our expectation that each night we will get the news we need to better understand our part of the world. We will miss Dan Miller. Colleagues and competitors alike respect him. Somehow, for a while, it will not be the same. I'm Ed Kimbrell.
Tonight on Talkback, several viewers expressed their feelings about Dan. Here's Sharon Puckett.
Mrs. Beverly Roy of Mount Juliet said she's sad to see Dan leave. She writes Talkback. Although I don't know him personally, nor have I ever met him, he certainly is a part of my family. He has become, during the past 15 years, a newsman whom you could trust in, believe in, and depend upon to deliver the best newscast anywhere. He is a true legend. Caroline Gardner said she is terribly upset to see Dan go. She writes, "It is the end of an era. Outwardly, the tears do not come, but inwardly, I am wrenched. There is a void. Dan Miller is the composite of the supreme gifted orator. His easiness on the eyes only accentuated his greatness. His grace, his finesse, his cool under pressure, his courtesy, his unbelievable good looks, his distinguishing tallness, every attribute he possesses make him the consummate broadcaster." And Barbara Baggett of Springfield said she's sad that Dan will soon leave. She writes, "I wish there was something that could be done to get him to stay, but if he feels this is the time in his life he needs to make a change, then all I can say is good luck to him, and I hope he will be happy. I know that I speak for many folks who watch and love Channel 4. The opinions expressed in letters used on Talkback in this case do represent the feelings of the management of Channel 4. I'm Sharon Puckett.
Should your name be on this envelope? It should be. If you or someone you love is age 50 to 80, and it will be addressed to you if you call now for the important information in this envelope. Free information that tells you how easy it is to get valuable life insurance protection with a whole life policy that is designed especially for men and women age 50 to 80. If you meet that age requirement, you are guaranteed this protection, because there's no physical examination and no medical questions. You cannot be turned down, regardless of your health. Your premium will be $6.95 a month and will never increase. And as you grow older, your benefits will never decrease. Some other policies designed for mature people actually reduce your benefits as you grow older. You may continue to pay their same premium, but they give you less and less coverage. So don't be fooled. Be careful. Go ahead and compare Colonial Penn with other companies. So get ready to make that important telephone call right now. If you call now, Colonial Penn Life Insurance Company will send you the important information in this envelope, and it's free. So if you are age 50 to 80, shouldn't you join the millions of people who have already called for this offer? Shouldn't you call now? Here's the number.
Call 800-468-0500 for free information in the mail about the life insurance Ed McMahon spoke about.
The information is free and the call is free. So call now, 800-468-0500. 800-468-0500. That's 800-468-0500.
Is it 17 years? 17?
Almost. Come November would be. Okay.
One of the good things about sticking around that long is you don't have to endure things like this.
That's right.
We're about to do something here. When it was first announced that you would be leaving Channel 4, you know, the phones were ringing. The letters came pouring in. It seemed like the entire city wanted to say goodbye. We couldn't get to all of you, but we did reach a few of Dan's friends and fans.
Good evening. Federal prosecutors ask an appeals judge today to deny Ray Blanton's request for a new trial.
He's been part of Nashville's dinner hour for nearly 17 years. He may just be the most popular man in the Mid-South.
Who's Dan Miller? Seriously, who's Dan Miller?
He's probably running for some kind of city office.
No.
He's certainly not the mayor of the city.
No.
I have no idea.
Bill Hall is coming. Any minute now with the weather on a beautiful day.
Thank you, Daniel.
Those who know Dan Miller love him like a member of the family. For some, saying goodbye can be difficult.
Oh, no. I can't believe it. I love to hear the news from here.
I watched him when I was this high. I'm going to miss him, man.
It's the worst thing that has ever happened to TV.
He's a tradition here in Nashville.
Oh, we love him. What else can I say?
In his 17 years on the scene at 6, Dan has seldom been at a loss for words. But even Nashville's top anchor man could be caught off guard. One night it started with an impromptu weather script.
Miss Patrick, anything particular you'd like to talk about tonight?
Well, you know, we talked earlier that we didn't know what we were going to talk about. The weather has been a little dull. Nice, but quiet. And I did something. This is legitimate, folks. I wrote a script for us. You just
this
read...
It's all scripted.
You've not seen this, right?
No, I haven't.
You just read the parts marked Dan.
Is this clean? I mean, I can read this on the air. Cold.
Well, I'd be careful. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Well, where's Boyce tonight, Pat?
He's taking the day off today, Dan, but he'll be back tomorrow.
Well, it's great having you here. You're one of the most talented broadcasters in the country, and you're a real asset to this show.
Gosh, Dan, you didn't have to say that.
By the way, Pat, what time is your radio show on?
Nice of you to ask, Dan. It's from 2:30 until 5, Monday through Friday, on WSM 650 on your dial.
I personally think it's one of the top radio programs in the country.
Gosh, Dan, you didn't have to say that.
How about the weather?
Excuse me, Matt, this is really embarrassing.
Another embarrassing moment involved a pig named Porky.
That remains one of the most talked about stories we have ever had on.
That's understandable.
It's nice to have that on during the dinner hour, too.
A lot of people think it's disgusting.
Well, we get phone calls saying that. A lot of people like it. A lot of people don't like it. But they all comment on it, so we've shown it again after it being kind of shoved away in the back of the cabinet for the last 5 years.
Okay, you've never followed up on Porky again.
Well, we attended his first and second birthday parties. Unfortunately, there was no third birthday party because in 1973, Porky... You know, we knew we wouldn't be able to do this. Porky went on a journey.
A journey?
He went on a journey.
He died.
Yeah, he died.
This is awful. I mean, we're sorry about Porky dying.
That's why we haven't done this story in 5 years, because we knew we wouldn't be able to get through this part.
The price of meat was awful, babe.
No, no. Porky went on a journey to the great smokehouse in the sky. And actually, he died in the living room.
Did he?
Yes, they had to get a piano lift to get him out of the house.
That's sad.
And they buried him in the backyard.
Huh.
So they did not eat Porky. They buried him in the backyard. And I talked with Mrs. Nelson yesterday and asked her if they had gotten another pet pig. Mm-hmm. No, they don't have another pet pig. Now they have a pet chihuahua.
Dan's been a familiar face not only to news viewers, but those who stay up late on Sunday nights.
He got another show on TV. What is it? What is it? What is it? Dan Miller Show? What
is it? Miller & Company.
Miller & Company. That's it. That's it.
Through the years, Miller & Company has brought big names to Nashville with friendly conversations over cups of coffee. Even the big stars couldn't resist a chance to say goodbye.
Well, he's going to L.A., you know. And I'd just like to tell him we're going to miss him for all 2 weeks. He's going to be coming back here in about 2 weeks. No, every time I go to L.A., you know, about the second week I'm out there, I start wanting to kick old ladies or something. But he'll enjoy it, you know, and they're getting the best. He is the best.
Well, I'm sad. I'm sad, but I'm proud for him, because that's what this life is all about. And I can't blame him for taking advantage of the opportunity that comes along. If I were in his shoes, I'd do the same thing. But, of course, we'll miss him very much.
I wish you good luck and Godspeed. I know you'll do those folks a really good job. I'll miss you, Dan.
Oh, one more thing, Dan. You know, people always want to know what folks like yourself and me and other people here in the public are. They want to know what we're like off camera. And seriously, I just want to tell them that when you get out from behind the desk and off television and, you know, just the normal person, that you're just, well, Dan Miller is all heart.
I'm surprised that Dan Miller has escaped the big time this long, because he certainly has the warmth and the believability of a Walter Cronkite. And I'm going to miss him in Nashville, my family and I, because we always would tune in and watch Mr. Dan Miller. I loved his Sunday night show, and I know that you're going to do well. And I'm going to look you up when I get out there, Dan, okay? Good luck there, partner.
You know, Nashville will miss Dan Miller. I'm going to miss Dan Miller. Hi, this is Les Jameson. This is The Scene at 6. Huh? How about that?
I hear that somebody's leaving the station, yeah. Senator.
Yes, Mr. Enemy, I hear that Don Miller is leaving.
Who?
Don Miller.
Don Miller?
And I'd like to say peace, prosperity go with you. And don't forget what we say down south. Don't get too friendly with men with earrings. That's California, you know.
Dan, knowing you as I do, and I think I know you pretty well, some of it's good, some of it might be questionable. I've called my good friend Darrell Gates out in L.A., who's the chief of police there, and give him a little bit about your background, and he's going to be on the lookout for you and hopefully give you some guidance out there.
Dan, Sandra and I are really sorry to see you leave Nashville, but we're so proud of you. And as a memento, we have two cups with the Nashville skyline. You gave us two of your, Dan, what's that, Dan something and company? Dan Miller and Company coffee cups when we were on your program. We'd like for you to remember us and to remember Nashville with this beautiful skyline that you had a great part in creating.
Having Dan Miller just leave on a certain night is like telling your five-year-old that you can't have his teddy bear anymore. He's going to take it away that night and never see it again. It would be nicer if we could have the teddy bear taken away a little piece at a time, and maybe the teddy bear or Dan could be there on Tuesdays and then once every couple of weeks or something like that. I wish Dan well. My fondest hope is that Dan will go out to that evil western city and find whatever happened to Floyd Kephart.
Well, Dan, I just want to say goodbye, and I'll miss you. I remember all those days you invited me over to your house to watch tapes of your old newscast. Dan, I hope you do well in Los Angeles. Oh, how I hope you do well in Los Angeles. Good luck, pal.
Good morning, Dan.
It is 8 a.m. Do you remember what that feels like? Only your leaving town would get me up at such an hour. I even had to drag my kid out with me. But we figured, what the heck, it's worth it. It's not every day that Dan Miller leaves town. You realize, of course, you're about the only one left in that newsroom that I haven't had a chance to work with. Oh, yeah, I thought about coming over there, but every time the opportunity came up, Bill Hall would call me up and invite me to go hunting. So I figured I better stay where I am. But on a very serious note, I wish you all the best, and I'm going to miss you. I'm really going to miss you. And you know the old saying, you can never go home? In your case, Dan, I hope that's true. Good luck.
When I first heard Dan was leaving, my reaction was a selfish one. I felt sad that my friend Dan Miller would no longer be a part of the Channel 4 scene. And then I realized that, Dan, you deserve a better job in a bigger market. Now, I want you to do all of us a big favor, Dan. When you go to the West Coast, please do not tell all those people that a few years ago, you were named as one of the best-dressed men in Nashville, Tennessee. I'm not sure that would help the image of Music City, USA. Now, seriously, we're all glad that you have this opportunity to advance personally, professionally, and financially. You may be sure that we'll follow your career with interest, and we join with thousands of others in wishing for you the very best. You have paid the price. You have a marvelous opportunity. And in my mind, you have all the ability in the world. Good luck to you. Go get it.
Now let's check the weather. Dan Miller. Well, it's been an ideal day for outdoor activities in South Carolina with sunny, warm conditions. However, increasing cloudiness is expected tomorrow, and showers and thundershowers are likely tomorrow night. And I'll have more on that in a moment. Remember that person? Can you believe it? Pat Sajak, who now works at KNBC in Los Angeles, modeling a, is that a clergy shirt? Sells for $36. They want to know how we're going to go for each other's throat. Why don't we arm wrestle right off the bat?
Somebody on my staff suggested that too, that we just do that.
And get it out of the way.
That's right. No more rating books.
What does your daddy do here at WIS-TV? What does he do on television? I'm sure you see him all the time. Does he do weather? Mm-hmm. Is he a good weatherman?
On the national weather map, first of all, here in the southeast, high pressure and warm southerly breezes gave us a very pleasant day in the southeast today. And in fact, over all of the eastern seaboard, temperatures reached into the 70s as far north as New York State today. And it's been very nice.
Stephen, what is your favorite food? What do you like to eat best?
Steak.
You like steak. Do you have steak at the house very often? You do, I see.
And now you know I can't smile without you. I can't smile without you. I can't laugh and I can't sing. I'm finding it hard to do anything. You see, I feel sad when you're sad. I feel glad when you're glad. If you only knew what I'm going through, I just can't smile. Now some people say, happy this day.
Gee whiz, I think I should be dead or something. You know?
It feels like that, doesn't it?
I don't know what to say. That's wonderful.
Well, we put a lot of time into it, and a lot of people just wanted to say, we couldn't even fit all the people that wanted to say goodbye.
Oh, I'm touched. I don't know what else to do.
Okay, and we're going to start with the goodbyes, I guess, with Bill Hall.
Okay, Demetria. Dan, this is just a small memento of your fellow employees here and other people. It's a huge sign that says, Goodbye, Dan, and it was signed by, I think, just about everybody in the newsroom. The lipstick belongs to Merle Purvis.
Yeah, and, I should have known.
But that's just a goodbye. And I think I can best sum things up with a poem, a letter that came in the mail just today. I'll read this. It says, Our Anchorman, I came to town the other day. I turned on TV. I heard a man say, Good evening, I'm Dan Miller. I listened to his news, the good and the bad, then a few comments that made us sad. He spoke of the weather while looking at Bill Hall, the pork and chitlins, and the map on the wall. Bill gave the weather, and now back to Dan. They brought on the commercials and the sportsman. When the news, the weather, and the sports were through, Dan said, I've got something to say and do. I'm leaving Channel 4 and Friends for years. I'll miss you all. There were no tears. I'm going out west where the sun shines bright, the sports are good, and the price is right. These comments were made to all of his fans. Good luck and happiness, we say, to tall, handsome Dan. From Mr. W.G. King of Nashville, Tennessee, and I would like to say that I won't mess things up by getting teary-eyed. I've respected you. I love you. I'll miss you a great deal, and best of luck to you.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay, Rudy.
Couple of things. A Wheel of Fortune game.
All right. Thanks. A parting gift.
For those, and here.
Oh, yeah.
For your rear, for appropriately scented for Los Angeles.
It'll look good. Okay. Thanks, Rudy. Can I say something here very quickly? And I will keep this short. We're about out of time. And I wrote this out because I didn't think I'd be able to think right now. First, I want to thank the people I've worked with and for here in Nashville. Their strength has become my own. And thanks to the city of Nashville, it has welcomed me and become my home. Two of my children were born here, and virtually every close friendship that I cherish was born, and they'll be a part of me always. And more than you know, I appreciate the letters and the expressions of support, the good wishes, especially in recent weeks. I'm confident that whoever ends up in this news desk in the future will find the same friendship and support that has meant so much to me. Thanks for everything.